Welcome to STEMinism Club.
Hi. So in this lesson, we're going to be learning about how to use clones and Scratch to organize your programs in a new way called object-oriented programming. This is a lesson for more advanced Scratchers to improve their skills. It can also serve as a jumping-off point to learn a more complex object-oriented language, such as Java. So what even is this object-oriented programming? It's not a language of its own, but it's a tool that many other programming languages use. Object-oriented programs are organized into sections called classes, which are a bit like sprites in Scratch, except that they represent a whole family of things instead of one specific thing. To create these specific things, known as instances of a class, you can use clones in Scratch. So today we're going to code a frog pond, so let's make a frog class. But we can't just have a pond with one frog, so what we can do is we can duplicate the frog sprite and just make a bunch of frogs. But programmers are lazy, so there's a better way to do this. And that way is using clones. We have this one frog class right here, we can call it the frog mom, and suddenly we can use clones to create a bunch of different frogs using only one sprite. These are called instances of a specific class. Now our frog mom can make as many frogs as she wants, or in more technical terms, we can make many different instances of the frog class. Or if you wanted to get really crazy, you could use a loop. How many frogs do you want? 10? 100? 1,000? So maybe that's a little too many frogs. Now we need a way to keep track of all of our frogs. So let's make a variable for counting frogs. And let's call it something simple, like ID. And we also want to make sure to check for the sprite only. What this means is that every clone of frog, or every instance of the frog class, has its own copy of the variable. These variables specific to instances are known as fields. So now we have a basic script that makes 5 instances of the frog class. Okay, now that we have all of our frogs with their ID fields, let's make the frogs say their IDs so we can see them. We can use the when I start as a clone block to give each frog clone code to run as soon as it's created by the mom frog. From there, we just insert ID into the say and we're good to go. And what we can see is right now all of these frogs have the same ID of 0, which is the same as the mom. But maybe we want our frog mom to be a little bit more creative, so we can try changing the ID of each of her frog clones. Take a moment to think to yourself what this code would do, and feel free to pause the video if you need more time. Now, as you can see, we have a whole chorus of frogs, each with their own fields. This is the power of clones. Think about how many different variables you'd have to make if each of these frogs had been their own different sprite. Another interesting thing to note is that in Scratch, every sprite that you create as representing a class has a couple of hidden fields in addition to the variables you create. For example, the x and y coordinates of the sprite, the direction that it's facing, any visual effects, and even if the sprite is shown or hidden. Each of the frog instances inherits their x and y positions from the frog mom, so if we hadn't changed the position, the frogs would all be stacked on top of each other. Now where do you go next? There are a number of different projects you could make using clones. You could have a color variable and then change the color effects of each of the instances of the frog. You could have a health variable. If you're doing a fighting game, you could have each of the enemies to keep track of its own health. Or you could also have a name if you think that the frog mom using numbers is too uncreative. So now that you know this vocabulary about classes, instances, and fields, you have a lot of new projects that you can work on. And you can also look into other object-oriented languages, such as Java. As a quick review, in object-oriented programming, your code is organized into classes. And once you have these generic objects, you can create as many instances of them as you like. And each of these instances will have their own characteristics, known as fields, which can be things like variables that are specific to the sprite, or their position, or whether they're shown or hidden. I hope you enjoyed this video and learned something. Thanks for watching.